He began his quest from the garage of his home in Canada.
I was the welder, I was the painter, and only one employee in the company.
With a handful of tools, German Guterov set out to build his first armored car. He recognized its value as a niche market.
Originally, I came from Russia, and I was in the police force for 5 years. Then I see so many criminal situations happening, and I decided to bring something that can protect the people. And I started to look for armored cars, and I end up making them myself.
That was back in 1996. Today, Guterov is at the helm of the Straight Group, the largest privately owned armored vehicle company in the world. He operates his business not from Canada or Russia, but from Ras Al Khaimah, or RAK for short, in the United Arab Emirates.
Feel very comfortable to stay in Ras Al Khaimah because we...
We got a space. This is the group's single largest operation.
This building particularly is 400,000 square feet. We have 386 employees as right now, but we will be by next 6 months around 500 employees.
Guterov says he chose to locate here because the business practices suited them and it was more cost effective than some of its neighbors.
We visit UAE, we visit Kuwait, Jordan, Iraq. And our choice was UAE.
140 vehicles a month are currently produced in the RAK plant. Every part of the process is done in-house. So when a commercial car is first brought in, it's stripped of all of its interiors. The upholstery, the wiring, brought right down to the very bare bones. It takes 4 to 10 days to armor the car from the ground up. Straight says 70% of the cars are made for commercial rather than military security vehicles. The bulk of the business is armoring commercial vehicles, and the trick is to keep it low profile. This bus, for instance, looks ordinary from the outside. On the inside, it's reinforced by steel. This bus is being shipped to Iraq to a client who wants to transport his employees from the accommodation to the job site safely. Vehicles assembled here are exported all over the world. But Guterov says with the volatility in the region, the Middle East is still the largest market.
I would say probably 30% is the Middle East, and the rest of the world is around 70%. Different political situation, different country. We'll see some progress is going on in Africa and also near Asia, South Asia.
Guterov plans to double the capacity at the RAK plant and increase production of its military vehicles.
Next year we should be going to 60% commercial, 40% military side. Purpose is the same. They have to protect the lives. They have to save the soldiers. They have to save VIPs, individuals and governmental entities.
Gearing up to expand his business in RAK to meet the rising demand for security worldwide. Leone Lakhani, Ras Al Khaimah in the United Arab Emirates.